Let us pray. Almighty God, unto whom our hearts be open, all desires known, and from whom no secret is silent, cleanse the thoughts of our hearts by the inspiration of thy Holy Spirit, that we may perfectly love thee and worthily magnify thy holy name, through Christ our Lord. Amen. Take away from us, we beseech thee, O Lord, our iniquities, that we might be worthy to enter with pure minds into the Holy of Holies. Let us confess our sins to God Almighty. We confess to God Almighty, the Father, the Son, and the Holy Ghost, that we have sinned in thought, word, and deed, through our own weak fault. Wherefore we pray God to have mercy upon us.
Thank you. church in Jerusalem, and they sent Barnabas to Antioch. When he came and saw the grace of God, he was glad, and he exhorted them all to remain faithful to the Lord with steadfast purpose. For he was a good man, full of the Holy Spirit and of faith, and a large company was added to the Lord. So Barnabas went to Tarsus to look for Saul, and when he had found him, he brought him to Antioch. For a whole year they met with the church and taught a large company of people. And in Antioch, the disciples were, for the first time, called Christians. Now in these days, prophets came down from Jerusalem to Antioch. And one of them, named Agabus, stood up and foretold by the Spirit that there would be a great famine over all the world. And this took place in the days of Claudius. And the disciples determined, every one according to his ability, to send relief to the brethren who lived in Judea. And they did so, sending it to the elders by the hand of Barnabas and Saul. This is the word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God. Psalm 37, verses 1 to 11.
Oh,
Gospel of our Lord Jesus Christ according to John.
Some of the saints have great nicknames. St. John the Divine, Gregory Thaumaturgos, which means wonder worker, James and John Boanerges, the Sons of Thunder. Perhaps that's a good name for a band. This evening we celebrate Barnabas, whose nickname is the Son of Encouragement. He is described as full of the Holy Spirit in the book of Acts. Jesus calls the Holy Spirit the Comforter, which makes us in the modern day think of Consoler, but the older meaning of Comforter is Encourager, as in the section in the Bayeux Tapestry labelled Bishop Otto comforts his troops, and the bishop is depicted prodding his men with his sword, a rather sharp kind of encouragement. The Holy Spirit is the bringer of God's encouragement. And St. Barnabas, being full of the Spirit, is a child of this encouragement. Barnabas did indeed encourage the early church in Antioch, but there is one person in particular whom Barnabas encouraged, the man he sent to, who he went to Tarsus to bring back to assist him, Saul, later known as Paul. Barnabas took Paul on as his protege. In chapter 11 and 12 of Acts, Barnabas appears to be the senior partner. But by chapter 13, Paul was taking on more of an apostolic role in his own right. Barnabas has successfully encouraged and enabled his junior colleague. In the terms of the modern church, Barnabas was Paul's training cadet. And as is often the experience of junior and senior colleagues, once Paul found his feet, he disagreed with his mentor on the question specifically of not eating with Gentile Christians, telling Barnabas that not to do so undermined the gospel, and eventually going his separate way with his own protege, Silas. The apprentice had been encouraged to come into his own, so the teacher, the encourager, took a final backward step and let his erstwhile assistant go his own way in response to the Spirit. What are we to take from all this? Surely that we are called to encourage one another. And that's not simply to say to one another, well done, nice job, or you're all right, keep going, but to help another person to become more fully who God means them to be, to draw out from others their best self, to affirm and enable them in their gifts and skills, and to name them as a child of God, to allow the Spirit, the great encourager, to call and draw and build them up into the likeness of Christ through you. God has chosen us in Christ, we heard in the Gospel reading. He has chosen us to go and bear fruit, to encourage others to take hold of life in all its fullness, the life that Jesus offers to them. The fullness of life that we glimpse in the beauty of music and worship, and in the love and service between friends and strangers. We are called to encourage one another as Barnabas encouraged Paul. At the altar this evening, we meet with the God who calls us to be children of encouragement. As you meet him in bread and wine, may you know that encouragement in your life.
Let your light so shine before men that they may see your good works and glorify your Father which is in heaven. Our offertory hymn is number 574.
Thank you.
ever-living God, who by thy holy apostle has taught us to make prayers and supplications, and to give thanks for all them, we humbly beseech thee most mercifully to accept our alms and oblations, and to receive these our prayers, which we offer unto thy divine majesty, beseeching thee to inspire continually the universal church with the spirit of truth, unity, and concord. And grant that all they that do confess thy holy name may agree in the truth of thy holy word, and live in unity and godly love. We beseech thee also to save and defend your Christian kings, princes, and governors, and especially thy servant Elizabeth our Queen, that under her we may be godly and quietly governed. And grant unto her whole council, and to all that are put in authority under her, that they may truly and impartially minister justice, to the punishment of wickedness and vice, and to the maintenance of thy true religion and virtue. Give grace, O Heavenly Father, to all bishops, priests, and deacons, that they may both by their life and doctrine set forth thy true and lively word, and rightly and duly administer thy holy sacraments. And to all thy people give thy heavenly grace, and especially this congregation here present, that with meek heart and due reverence they may hear and receive thy holy word, truly serving thee in holiness and righteousness all the days of their life. And we most humbly beseech thee of thy goodness, O Lord, to comfort and succour all them who in this transitory life are in trouble, sorrow, need, sickness, or any other adversity. And we commend to thy gracious keeping, O Lord, all thy servants departed this life in thy faith and fear, especially those who have served thee among them by affection, beseeching thee to grant them everlasting light and peace. And we give thee thanks for all thy saints, and especially for the Blessed Virgin Mary, Barnabas, Lawrence, and Nicholas, who have been the chosen vessels of thy grace and lights of the world in their several generations. And we pray that, rejoicing in their fellowship and following their good examples, we may be partakers with them of thy heavenly kingdom. Grant this, O Father, for Jesus Christ's sake, our only mediator and our God. Amen. Hear what comfortable words our Saviour Christ saith unto all that truly turn to him. Come unto me, all that travail and are heavy laden, and I will refresh you. So God loved the world, that he gave his only begotten Son, to the end that all that believe in him should not perish, but have everlasting life. Here also what St. Paul said, this is a true saying, and worthy of all men to be received, that Christ Jesus came into the world to save sinners. Here also what St. John said, if any man sin, we have an advocate with the Father, Jesus Christ the righteous, and he is the propitiation for our sins. We do not presume to come to this thy table, O merciful Lord, trusting in our own righteousness, but in thy high fold of great mercies. We are not worthy so much as to gather up the crumbs of thy table, but thou art the same Lord, whose nature is always to have mercy. Grant us therefore, gracious Lord, so to be the flesh of thy dear Son Jesus Christ, and to drink his blood, that our sinful bodies may be made clean by his body, and our souls washed through his most precious blood, and that we may ever all dwell in him, and he in us. Amen. The Lord be with you.
And with thy spirit.
Lift up your hearts.
We lift them up to God.
to suffer death upon the cross for our redemption. He made there, by his one oblation of himself once offered, a full, perfect, and sufficient sacrifice, oblation, and satisfaction for the sins of the whole world, and did institute, and in his holy gospel, command us to continue a perpetual memory of that his precious death until his coming again. Hear us, O merciful Father, we most humbly beseech thee, and grant that we receive in these thy creatures of bread and wine, according to thy Son, our Saviour Jesus Christ's holy institution, in remembrance of his death and passion, may be partakers of his most blessed body and blood. During the same night that he was betrayed, he took bread, and when he had given thanks, he broke it, and gave it to his disciples, saying, Take, eat. This is my body which is given for you. Do this in remembrance of me. Likewise, after supper, he took the cup, and when he had given thanks, he gave it to them, saying, Drink ye all of this, for this is my blood of the New Testament, which is shed for you and for many for the remission of sins. Do this as oft as ye shall drink it, in remembrance of me. Wherefore, O Lord and Heavenly Father, we thy humble servants, having in remembrance the precious death and passion of thy dear Son, his mighty resurrection and glorious ascension, entirely desire thy fatherly goodness, mercifully to accept this our sacrifice of praise and thanksgiving. Most humbly beseeching thee to grant that by the merits and death of thy Son Jesus Christ, and through faith in his blood, we and all thy whole church may obtain remission of our sins, and all of the benefits of his passion. And here we offer and present unto thee, O Lord, ourselves, our souls and bodies, to be a reasonable, holy, and living sacrifice unto thee, humbly beseeching thee that all we who are partakers of this holy communion may be fulfilled with thy grace and heavenly benediction. And although we be unworthy through our manifold sins to offer unto thee any sacrifice, yet we beseech thee to accept this our abandoned duty and service, not weighing our merits but pardoning our offences, through Jesus Christ our Lord, by whom and with whom and in him, in the unity of the Holy Ghost, all honour and glory be unto thee, O Father Almighty, world without end. Amen. Amen. Our Father, which art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, in earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive them who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. For thine is the kingdom, the power, and the glory, for ever and ever. Amen. The peace of the Lord be always with you, and with us.
Thank you.
Behold him that taketh away the sins of the world. Blessed are those who are called to the supper of the Lamb.
Lord, I am not ready to receive thee, but let me say the word, and my soul shall be
Savior Jesus Christ, and dost assure us thereby of thy favor and goodness. witness towards us, and that we are very members incorporate in the mystical body of thy Son, which is the blessed company of all faithful people, and are also heirs to the hope of thy everlasting kingdom, by the merit of the most precious death and passion of thy dear Son. And we most humbly beseech thee, O Heavenly Father, so to assist us with thy grace, that we may continue in that holy fellowship, and do all such good works as thou hast prepared for us to walk in, through Jesus Christ our Lord, to whom with thee and the Holy Spirit, your honour and glory, world without end. Amen. The Lord be with you.
And with thy spirit.
The peace of God which passeth all understanding, keep your hearts and minds in the knowledge and love of God, and of his Son Jesus Christ our Lord, and the blessing of God Almighty, the Father, the Son, and the Holy Ghost, be amongst you and remain.